Let's start to formalize the problem of learning a good word embedding. When you implement an algorithm to learn a word embedding, what you end up learning is an embedding matrix. Let's take a look at what that means. Let's say, as usual, we're using our 10,000 word vocabulary. So the vocabulary is A, Aaron, Orange, Zulu, maybe also unknown word as a token. What we're going to do is learn a embedding matrix E, which is going to be a 300 dimensional by 10,000 dimensional matrix, if you have 10,000 words in vocabulary, or maybe 10,001 if the unknown word token is one extra token. And the columns of this matrix will be the different embeddings for the 10,000 different words you have in your vocabulary. So orange was word number 6257 in our vocabulary of 10,000 words. So one piece of notation we'll use is that 06257 was the one hot vector with zeros everywhere and a 1 in position 6257. And so this would be a 10,000 dimensional vector with a 1 in just one position. So this isn't quite drawn to scale, I guess. This should be as tall as the embedding matrix on the left is wide. And if the embedding matrix is called capital E, then notice that if you take E and multiply it by this one hot vector, by O of 6257, then this will be a 300 dimensional vector. So E is 300 by 10,000 and O is 10,000 by 1. So the product will be 300 by 1. So it'll be 300 dimensional vector. And notice that to compute the first element of this vector, of this 300 dimensional vector, what you do is you would multiply the first row of the matrix E with this, but all of these elements are zero except for element 6257. And so you end up with zero times this, zero times this, zero times this, and so on. And then one times whatever this is, and then zero times this, zero times this, and zero times this, and so on. And so you end up with the first element as, you know, whatever is that element up there under the orange column. And then for the second element of this 300 dimensional vector we're computing, you would take the vector 06257 and multiply it by the second row of the matrix E. So again, you have 0 times this plus 0 times this plus 0 times all of these other elements, and then 1 times this, and then 0 times everything else, and add that together. And so you end up with this, and so on as you go down the rest of this column. So that's why the embedding matrix E times this one hot vector here winds up selecting out this 300 dimensional column corresponding to the word orange. So this is going to be equal to E6257, which is the notation we're going to use to represent the embedding vector, the 300 by 1 dimensional vector for the word orange. And more generally, E for specific word W, this is going to be the embedding for a word W. And more generally, E times O subscript J, one hot vector with a 1 at position J, this is going to be EJ, and that's going to be the embedding for word J in the vocabulary, word J in the vocabulary. So the thing to remember from this slide is that our goal will be to learn an embedding matrix E. And what you see in the next video is you initialize E randomly and then use gradient descent to learn all the parameters of this 300 by 10,000 dimensional matrix. And E times this one hot vector gives you the embedding vector. Now, just one note, when we're writing out equations, it'll be convenient to write this type of notation where you take the matrix E and multiply it by the one hot vector O. But when you're implementing this, it is not efficient to actually implement this as a matrix vector multiplication, because the one hot vectors, you know, this is a relatively high dimensional vector and most of its elements are zero. So it's actually not efficient to use a matrix vector multiplication to implement this, because you'd be multiplying a whole bunch of things by zeros. And so in practice, you'd actually use a specialized function to just look up a column of the matrix E rather than do this with a matrix multiplication. But when writing out the math, it's just convenient to write it out this way. But so in Keras, for example, there is a embedding layer. And if you use the embedding layer, then it more efficiently just pulls out the column you want from the embedding matrix rather than does it with a, you know, much slower matrix vector multiplication. So in this video, you saw the notation we'll use to describe the algorithms for learning these embeddings. And the key terminology is this matrix capital E, which will contain all the embeddings for the words in your vocabulary. In the next video, we'll start to talk about specific algorithms for learning this matrix E. Let's go on to the next video.